Hello Bookish Friends, welcome to my December wrap-up part 3. In this video, like I did in the previous months, I will first of all talk about the monthly bookish statistics. And then in the second part of the video, I will talk about the yearly reading challenges and the monthly readathons that I participated in December and give a summary of how I did with all of these events. In the month of December, I read a total number of 16 works. Among these 16 works, 11 of them were mystery, 2 were historical fiction, 2 were romance, and 1 was fantasy. I read a total number of 3,696 pages in December. I read 3 works less than 100 pages, 2 works between 100 and 200 pages, 7 books between 200 and 300 pages, 3 books between 300 and 400 pages, and 1 book between 500 and 600 pages. My average page number per book amounted to 231 pages. I read 1 book published in 1910s, 2 books published in 1920s, 5 books published in 1930s, 1 book published in 1990s, 1 book published between the years 2000 and 2009, 2 books published in 2010s, 2 books published in 2020 and 2021, and 2 books published in 2022. I read 13 works originally written in English, 2 works originally written in Turkish, and 1 work originally written in Spanish. I read the Spanish book in its Turkish edition. In the month of December, I read 9 novels, 3 short stories, 2 short story collections, 1 novella, and 1 graphic novel. 14 works that I've read were targeted towards adults. 1 was targeted towards middle grade, and 1 was targeted towards young adults. I read 8 e-books, 6 audiobooks, and 2 paperbacks. I rated 1 book 5 out of 10, 8 works 7 out of 10, 4 works 8 out of 10. 10, 2 books 9 out of 10, and 1 book 10 out of 10. My average rating for December was 7.56, which was quite a high rating compared to the other months. So I can say that this month has been a very good reading month. In the year 2022, I'm joining 2 yearly reading challenges. One is series about series, which is created by Lizzie Faye Loves Books. My overall aim for this readathon was to progress in 22 series. In December, I progressed in 2 series. I read the second volume of Heartstopper series by Alice Osman, and I read the second book in Inspector Alan Grant series by Josephine Tay, which was titled A Shilling for Candles. And as a total, I progressed in exactly 22 series in the year 2022, so I reached my goal by reading the second book in Heartstopper series in the month of December. The second yearly reading challenge was a Golden Girls Reading Challenge created by Rachel Fryman. And the prompt for December was a book featuring a wedding, and I read A Duke's Daughter by Kathleen Buckley, an e-arc from Book Siren. And the story of this book actually starts with an arranged marriage, so it fitted perfectly with the prompt. The first readathon that I participated in December was, of course, the Christie's Missing Readathon, which I am very proud to be a co-host of. And in this readathon, I was the team captain of Team Marple. Even though I don't have a competitive soul, I had great fun joining in the game and seeing how the team progressed. Though we didn't win the game and found Mrs. Christie, like Janelle said in her video, Team Marple forever. And the books that I read for the prompts for this readathon were, for a close circle mystery, I read the short story The Locked Room Library by Gigi Pandian. For the short story prompt, I read 2 short stories by Agatha Christie, Tuesday Night Club and The Adventure of the Christmas Pudding. For a Christie book featuring My Detective, I read Murder at the Vicarage by Agatha Christie. For a Golden Age author, I read a short story collection by the Detection Club, which included short stories from six different Golden Age authors. The title of the book was Six Against the Yard. For a retelling of or a book about Christie, I read Marple 12 New Mysteries by various authors. I did a reading blog about this book, which featured a very special guest. The group book was And Then There Were None by Agatha Christie. This book was a reread for me and I enjoyed it immensely. And there was an additional prompt. Each of the team captains chose an adaptation of an Agatha Christie book and did a watch along in the Discord group. As the team captain of Team Marple, I chose a 1980 version of The Mirror Cracked, featuring the late Angela Lansbury, as well as Elizabeth Taylor, Rock Hudson, and Kim Novak. We had a great time discussing the movie afterwards. Because of the time zone differences, I could not participate in the other hosts' watch-alongs, but I've heard that the participants also had a wonderful time. In summary, I had a great time co-hosting and participating in the Christie's Missing Readathon. I cannot wait to be a part of this wonderful readathon featuring my favorite author in the following years. Second monthly readathon that I participated was another mystery readathon, which fitted perfectly with the Christie's Missing Readathon. I actually used many of the books and the short stories for this readathon as well. There were reading prompt as well as other prompts. Managed to do all 12 of the prompts and reached Sherlock Holmes level. For the prompt of a partridge in a pear tree, we had to read an alliterative title, and I read the short story Miss Marple Takes Manhattan by Elsa Cole in the Marple 12 New Mysteries short story collection. For the prompt of two turtle doves, we had to do a bud read. And I used the group book And Then There Were None by Agatha Christie for the bud read. For French hands, we had to read translated work or book set in a different country from your own. I used a translated work, which was also set in a different country than mine, Turkey. I used Oxford Cinayetleri, The Oxford Murders by Guillerme Martinez. This book was originally written in Spanish and I read the Turkish edition, and the book of course took place in Oxford. For the prompt of calling birds, we had to read in nature or go for a walk. I listened the majority of the stories in Six Against the Yard by the Detection Club while walking. For the prompt of gold rings, we had to use a book with a foil on the cover. I used Marple 12 New Mysteries by various authors. As you can see, there's a foil in the ribbon. For the prompt of geese a-laying, have a cozy time eating Christmas treats and watch a cozy mystery. I will use the watch-along that I did. We watched The Mirror Cracked, like I mentioned before. And while watching, I ate some snacks. For the prompt of swans a-swimming, you have to have a soak in the bath, go for a swim, or walk in the rain or snow. It was raining when I was listening to The Agony Column by Earl Biggers in audiobook format. And that's why I will count this book for this prompt. For the prompt of Dingoes Dancing, we had to choose a wild card read, and I chose Lockroom Rivalry by Gigi Pandian.
Hello, it's editing Berna. I realized while editing that I skipped a prompt and mixed up the title of the next prompt. For the ninth prompt, which was Ladies Dancing, we had to have a festive night in or out to get in the festive cheer. I will use the Christofest discussion that we did, and we all dressed up as Christie characters, which was very festive in my opinion. And for the next prompt that I will mention in the video, which was Lords A-Leaping, we had to read a story with a nobility in it.
In the book The Wheel Spins by Ethan Lina White, one of the side characters is a baroness, and she is very important in the structure of the mystery too. For the prompt of Piper's Piping, we had to listen to cozy or Christmas music while reading. I listened to the Christmas playlist while reading Shilling for Candles by Josephine Tay. And it was Christmas Day, even though I don't celebrate Christmas. It was great to get in the mood of festivities. For the last prompt, which is drummer's drumming, we had to listen to a crime, true or fiction, narrative of my choice. I listened to the short story by Agatha Christie, The Adventure of the Christmas Pudding. It was one of the best Hercule Poirot short stories that I've read. And I'm very glad that I could use this short story for the last prompt and achieving Sherlock Holmes level. So this was my last wrap-up video of 2022. Please comment down below. Have you joined any of the mystery readathons? Or did you join any other readathon in December? I think December is a great month for reading, especially mysteries. If you're a new viewer, first of all, welcome. Please like and subscribe. Hope to see you very soon. Bye! As for Turkish word of the day, since I joined Cloak and Dagger Christmas readathon, I'm going to choose dagger. Dagger means hançer in Turkish, and hançer is our Turkish word of the day. Have a good day!